Emmanuel is a marketing professional with over 7 years' experience in developing innovative brand strategies across digital and traditional media. Emmanuel holds a master's degree in strategic marketing with a major in digital marketing and social media from the London Metropolitan University. He began his career as an IT technician at Kenya Ports Authority in 2006 and later joined Kenya Airways as a social media marketing intern in 2010 before rising to the position of digital marketing coordinator at Square Goal PR and Marketing, a position he held for 1 year. He later joined Brighter Monday, one of the largest human resource recruitment platforms in Kenya, as a marketing executive in 2012, rising to the regional marketing manager and later CEO. Please welcome Mr. Emmanuel Mutuma.
I think the beauty for me is to wind up a discussion from what has been shared previously and to sum it up with some data. As you understand, I'm with Brighter Monday, and Brighter Monday is the jobs platform which we all know, which links job seekers and employers in the markets. And you know, I just referred to it from a chat. Our culture as Kenyans, when you used to wait for the Friday newspaper to check the opportunities which are available for the week. And I think Brighter Monday was founded for that cause. Some time back, of course, without the internet access in the country, you'll find newspapers will travel to Turkana after 3 days. And it means most of the people will not have access to the real, you know, the opportunities in real time. And most of the candidates, of course, missed out on opportunities. So Brighter Monday is a source that avails the jobs within the platform to the audience. And we have employers, of course, who are looking for talent. And because I'm here today, I think, basically because we focus mainly and we have a huge chunk of millennials who have a big expectation from the brand, which I think, to be fair, we can't have 100% guarantee from the outcome because the employers decide the type of talent that they're going to hire for the organization. But at the same time, I was very interested to be part of this forum. When I had a chat with Ronnie, most of the young people asked me, why am I applying for 50 jobs within your platform and I've not been called for an interview? So I'm here just to crunch the numbers and share some of these numbers. Why? So as you can see, this is our audience base. It's quite big. We have over 800,000 registered candidates on the platform, with over 1 million sessions within our platform every month. You know, unique users, these are the unique users. 350,000 young people are looking for talent within our platform every month. I think I can refer back to what Rory shared. Over 50% of young people are looking to either get a new job or move. Maybe they are pissed off in their work environment and they need to move maybe to a different environment that understands them. On the other side, of course, we have the largest pool of employers who are looking for talent within our platform. Majorly SMEs and corporates. Kasime, maybe I understand you may be privileged to have application tracking system within your organization, but we know it doesn't come cheap. But Brighter Monday, of course, we serve the masses, and SMEs really find our products valuable to them, to reach to a wide target pool at a very convenient cost for them. And for the job seekers, of course, the service is free for them. So that's what makes it very special. The market data, based on the research that we've done, at any given time, we have 10,000 jobs in the market, 100,000 jobs in the market I have to underline that. Because it doesn't necessarily mean that we have 10,000 jobs in Kenya at any given time. Most of the jobs are shared through networks, referrals, headhunting is quite big, especially for the C-level. And you will find, if you're really looking for proven talent, especially for the high level, you'll use another source to do that. But the masses, who are the millennials, are looking for that first opportunity or looking for a space where they can call home within the platform. And of course, we understand the biggest employer in our country is the government. I had not looked at what Mr. Ronnie had shared with us earlier, but you can see this similarity between our internal data and the research that he's done. So from my understanding, millennials are the guys who are born between 1982 to 2000, and they fall in our first category, the most active audience, which brings us to 60%. If I'm not wrong, I think you had a research 58% or something. So you can see these are the most engaged users within our platform. And what do they look for? They are very keen in understanding the job. They know what they are, and you know, they search using keywords. So when they come to our platform, they come, of course, through Google. So they go to Google and they say, digital marketing job in Kenya. If you can do that search, you land on Brighter Mag as the first search. So search is our highest source of traffic. And at the same time, people are spending more and more time for looking for a match within their career. After that, people study the job description that are advertised, and lots of people spend a lot of time there. So this is a worrying number down here. Every month, we channel 120,000 job applications. And I think the people are asking me, why was my application not considered? And if I go back, you will see we have 5,000 jobs at the in the platform at any given time. So you can see there is a very big difference between the demand and the supply. If I refer back to Ronnie's presentation, I think IT and telecommunications was one of the categories which people are really active on. But for us, I think accounting, because we have so many people doing BA, BCom, and specializations within that. And we have a lot of young people looking for the opportunities in those categories. So I think the other part for me, I know we have HRs here within the audience, and a bit from me will be to educate them on how to ensure that they attract the right talent from what we have. And it has to be a two-way, I think, type of approach. So the requirements that employers are expected to do is to tailor the job description with the specific requirement that they're looking for. So if you're looking for someone vibrant in the job space, if you're looking for someone who is driven, if you're looking for someone who is outgoing, just write that within the job description. Because I think we've seen it again and again. You're looking for an accountant, you copy-paste a job description from I don't know which year, you put it out there, you're looking for something different, and you tell us you're not getting the people that you were actually looking for. So it's really good to have that content written the right way to attract the right person. Because you can see a lot of people are spending a lot of time studying the job description for themselves. And people can know, you know, this person is talking to me. This organization is looking for someone like me. And millennials will do whatever it takes to craft an application that shows that they are the perfect match for that job. The other thing employers have to do is to sell themselves. I think we are in a market where we feel, you know, sometimes I look at the government, I don't quote a lot of things about teachers go on strike, and the next statement I see as the headline in the newspaper is, we have a lot of young people who are looking for opportunities, so we hire them so you guys can stay up. I think that's not the right approach, especially for corporates and companies. You need to sell yourself, you need to attract the right candidates, they need to understand your culture, they have to be interested generally to work with you and follow. At any given time there's an opening because they know where they fit. The other thing I think as a connection to that, interviewing, you know, we should get away from the traditional way of getting a young person in an interview room with 10 head of departments and grill the hell out of that young man. It doesn't really bring out the true character of the individual. So that has to be a big change, because we find clients who are coming back to us and say, the candidates that came, they were really good on paper, but, you know, we didn't feel them. So we need to re-advertise the position again. You really need to think of ways to do an interview in a conducive environment, which will open up the individual, and they will really intrigue them much to the opportunity if you allow them that. Other things, you know, hiring for skills other than qualifications. We understand qualifications are okay, good. I don't expect someone who is looking for a finance director to get someone who doesn't have a basic degree in finance. But we understand the big engine of the organization is within the mid-level positions. And that's the biggest engine because of the energy that it's driven to power that engine. We have a few leaders who guide the teams, but of course, when you're looking for talent within the millennial space, look at the skill sets, look at the interests. Personally, I think I've done that a lot in my marketing career. We have something we call the career center, where we address young people, we give them tips on how to browse the job market, just to encourage them, because we know not everyone is getting a job and we need them the chances of getting opportunities. So as I worked in the career center, this is a blog, I was looking for writers, you know, really experienced writers, people who can deliver content to connect to the millennials. And one of the person that I got in was working as a receptionist and stroke accountant, stroke admin of an office in the organization. But they were running their own personal blog, which was really touching and connecting. Our writing was really artistic, flawless, could really connect to the three of us. And I brought her in as a consultant to write, and she was really good at it because she's a good researcher. Within a very short time, I told her, why don't you quit your full-time job and come do something that you really love, you know? This is your passion, this is what you like doing. She jumped for it really quick. And as I speak now, we are part of a bigger group called Radio One Africa Media, spread across sub-Saharan Africa. And within 8 months, she is currently the head of content, managing a team of like 20 people within the continent. So you can see, if I really went for her qualifications and asked her if she's done, I don't know what, journalism or whatever you can call it, I don't think she'd have that opportunity. So we really have to focus on the skills for the millennial. My friend here, I think, shared about Glassdoor. I really like Glassdoor. I think we're Glassdoor in the making, and there are key focus improvements that we have. You know, we're still evolving within our space. With time, there are lots of improvements, and one of the improvements that is really going to change is that we're going to use profiles rather than the CVs. Our profiles allows you to put in details within your skill sets, what you're really passionate about, what you've done before, rather than a CV, which we really start to write it in a very professional way. So the key goal of doing that is getting the keywords out of what an individual feels they're good at. The other thing is match candidates based on their personality. So we're integrating our platform with a platform called AmCat. To, you know, if you're applying for a job, you go through a set of questions that try to understand your personality. So that accompanies your application as a summary. So as an HR, as an employer, when you're making a decision on who is the perfect fit for your organization, you can actually see their personality and helps you really make the decisions really fast. The other thing, I know quite a number of you have gotten lots of emails from Bryce Monday. And why do we do that? It's because we believe we are distributing the job content to the masses. But I think that it's supposed to change. With social media, just, you know, it's time for relevance, you know. You have to get an alert that matches your profile. So we're going to work on matches based on the profile and the job description I just shared, who the employer has to put in place. The other cool feature, I think, which is really good with Glassdoor, is you can follow the company. So people don't come to Brighter Monday because they just want to come to Brighter Monday. They come to look for opportunities from different companies. So candidates or job seekers follow companies. So if you represent your brand so well, like Butter, then you'll find someone following the Butter activity and allows you to rate and comment or find out more about what they do in an informal way. So I think part of it, at the same time, the key requirements employers are looking for, again, is a convincing power. They're looking for good attitudes. They're looking for that drive. I think all these will be interpreted to, most of the time, to experience. You have to have 5 years experience. And, you know, all those are really basic. But the determining factor are the skill sets, which are, you know, the soft skills that comes, the package that comes with the individual. The other thing, of course, is the culture fit. You know, you really have to be structured for the right environment for maximum output or productivity. The other thing, you know, with 120,000 people applying for the jobs on our platform every month, what employers look at is just from their eyes through the applications that they come through, look for that unique selling point of an individual, and I think that's the game changer in terms of making a decision. Thank you.